Hello class, I'm Adele Van Bergen, and this is the video on German Expressionist painting. In particular, we're talking about portraits today. Now, the portraits that I'm most interested in are from the 1910s to the mid-1930s, pre-World War II Germany. So I've got some of my favorites that I want to show you. And a lot of these are very expressive, but one of the most interesting things about these portraits, they were all banned. And they were included in this show called the Degenerate Art Show, and it was curated by Hitler himself. He deemed these portraits as being dangerous. They weren't painted in the style that he considered beautiful, so he thought that they were a little threatening, and I'll let you be the judge of that. So we'll look at some of these, and I want you to tell me what you think. As your assignment, we're going to paint a portrait in the Expressionist style. So what I've got up here next, I've got a video of me doing my own attempt. I mean, this kind of painting can go in many different directions, so I've chosen one, and I'm going to give it a try here. So if you decide to do a background on your piece, spend 15 minutes on it. Next, I'm just putting in the outline, and I'm using vine charcoal. It's actually an old piece of wood that's been made into charcoal. It's one of the best for laying paintings out. You can just scrub your mistakes away with your fingers, no problems. As you can see, I'm working the whole painting all at once. Don't you dare get in there and start painting with a tiny little paintbrush. That's the wrong way to go with this. Keep your brushes big. Use a variety of lines. That means on the face, no eyelashes, no individual hairs. Go big. If it drips, well, that's okay. See how you like it. When you're thinking about color, think fast. Color right out of the tube with minimal mixing. You can mix right on a little palette. Don't bother mixing up paint in a cup or anything. Now as you paint, try to remember this is all about painting in the moment. This isn't about rendering or getting the figure just right. It's about using expressive mark. Put a mark down and leave it alone and walk away. Come back later and look at it and see what you think about it. You don't have to be a master of figure painting to do one of these paintings. I've chosen to paint this particular figure in this way because I know this person, and I wanted it to look sort of like it. Yet, I wanted to be expressive all at the same time. As you can see, my light is fading, so I'm having to paint really, really fast now. Don't let that bother you. So this is the final product. So thanks to the grumpy sitter, my teenage son. Please check out these artists who were used in this video. And also click on this annotation right here to check out this video for your next assignment. And special thanks to my computer guru. Thank you.